mission call, arterial dissection. That happened an hour before tip-off. VCU won that game by 21 points. The coach did return last year, but he's back feeling better this year. Lineups for our game today. Octavius Ellis might be the most talented player on the floor. The big for UC. And keep a close eye on Corey Bilbury starting today. Oral Roberts transfer replacing Jordan Burgess, who's out with a concussion. Tim Kelly, Mark Schnur, Eric Anderson, on-court officials today. VCU in the home yellows against Cincinnati, the American Conference. Here's Troy Copain. First possession for the Bearcats on the road. Big game today for each.
VCU starts man-to-man, which they play awful lot, but we're going to see some zone also from the Rams.
Rod Cobb to Ellis, top of the key. This is Clark with five to shoot. Spins. Left-handed jump hook is short. Fifth start of the year for Bilbury, the senior from Tulsa, Oklahoma. Here's Lewis, point guard for VCU.
We talked to Will Wade yesterday. He said, believe it or not, we want to slow it down. We're taking some bad shots. So we're a little slower pace now for the Rams.
What's that? Havoc? Slowing it down at VCU?
Half a Havoc, Dave.
Half a Havoc. Four to shoot here for Johnson. Floats. Tillman trying to knock that in. Gilmore close as well. Here comes Troy Copain. Brodkopf, the streaky three-point ace for Cincinnati.
From Cincinnati, want to go inside. The Rams are not as deep or as big, as physical as Cincinnati is.
From the free throw line, Copain gets a roll. Junior point guard leads the American Conference. Assists per game, leads the team, and right behind Daniel Hamilton of UConn. In dimes per game. Illegal screen is called. Michael Gilmore picks up his first.
That's one of the points of emphasis now this year is moving screens. Here we see, come on the baseline and try to get the ball to Johnson, a great shooter. Gilmore moved a little bit. Good call by the officials.
Bone shattering. Pick up top, Ellis frees, Copain for another.
When that layup goes in the first shot, Dave, your confidence grows and the basket looks as big as the Atlantic Ocean. So Copain is really feeling it right now after that layup.
Or the James River, right? We're close to the James River here.
Yep.
Richmond, the River City.
I'm a little weak in my rivers and geography.
You're a Virginia resident, you gotta know that, Pete.
I've been here forever, I'm a little shaky on the rivers.
Bilbury up top with eight to shoot. Here is Johnson, floats again. Front iron this time, a miss. Bilbury collects the offensive rebound, fresh 30. Johnson thought about a three, shot altered. Pass down low, Mo Alley Cox for the hammer.
Usually they go to a 2-2-1 zone press, but they want to slow it down a little bit right now. They don't want to run with Cincinnati. They want to slow the pace down because their offense has been shaky.
Rod Cobb, overplay. Bilbury almost a steal.
Rams get 10 steals a game, so they have active hands. They really get after you defensively.
Five to shoot. Copain pulls up, trying to stay hot. Front iron missed this time. Bilbury, defensive board. And the Rams on the move. Jaquan Lewis, freshman last year, was very solid. Took over for Briante Weber when he was hurt. Played well at the point for Shaka Smart. This year, inconsistent. Alley Cox lost it.
Got hit, I thought, that time, Dave.
Clark behind the back. Dribble sets up. The layup. Gary Clark, spectacular move in the open court. And it's a great start for Cincinnati.
Good defense leads to a layup. Bearcats are known for their great defense. They hold their opponents to only 59 points a game. And 37% from the field. Dave, that's outstanding.
12th best in the nation. Gilmore spins and scores. Michael Gilmore, the sophomore from Jacksonville, Florida. Nephew of Artis Gilmore, the former Jacksonville great and NBA and ABA star.
Great career. Heck of a move by Gilmore.
Anytime you mention Artis Gilmore, it's a good show.
No question. Great player.
Ball movement. Here's Farad Khan. Baseline. Does not get a roll. It's out of bounds. Early timeout. Hashtag resume builder. Hashtag signature win. It's a big one on CBS Sports Network.
Their opponent 66 points. They get 10 steals, and they cause 17 turnovers by their opponent. So two outstanding defensive teams, Dave.
The 59.1 points allowed per game by Cincinnati is 12th best in the nation on 347 Division I teams. Lewis off the steal. In transition block. And a goaltend call against Shaq Thomas. Count it for Lewis.
Nice attack to basket. Good call. Ball was on its way down. It's a good sign for Jaquan Lewis. He struggled the last couple of games. He had six turnovers against Georgia Tech and seven against Florida State, so he's off to a good start.
Started the last 15 games, as we talked about last year, when Briante Weber tore his ACL, played so well for Shaka Smart. Now the head man at Texas, Clark. Jump hook. Good start for Gary Clark, two field goals.
We see a 2-2-1 zone press by Cincinnati. They're trying to slow them down, get VCU out of their rhythm. Now there's less time on the clock, Dave, as you know, to execute their offense.
35 down to 30 this year. One of many rules changes in college basketball. I personally like it. Less time, possession, more offense, more chances like that from Cox. A miss. Gilmore keeps it alive on the baseline. Pass up top. Almost broken up. Comes Lewis, who floats. Short. Gilmore battling. That's a good start. And Shaq Thomas finds a loose change.
No place for the weak at heart in the lane there.
Copain, back iron. Octavius Ellis. Haven't mentioned his name much so far. Copain free. 4-3. And mom loves it. He's from Midlothian, Virginia, just outside Richmond. 40 family and friends are here to watch Troy Copain play here today.
The refs are letting a lot go, so it's advantage Cincinnati because they're bigger, stronger, all right, more experienced.
The only Cincinnati colors you see in this building are from the Copain family. Gilbert is fouled.
Nice job. The high post to kick it out to Copain all by himself. His mom is in the house. Yes. Yes, that's my son. Yeah, hey, mom.
Pretty happy.
Get him the ball, number 10.
He's got 7 points already. She's been cheering a lot here with the.
Yep, she's got number 10, just like her son.
Here's Renee. One more here for Bilber. It's his first point. 26 minutes against Georgia Tech the other night in a loss in Atlanta for VCU. Tillman's in for the first time. Gilmore, Mo Ali Cox are out. Ahmed Hamdi, first appearance. Junior forward from Egypt via JC in Texas. And he's played well for Will Wade this year.
Done a nice job. Big, strong guy. And I think he's going to be a big asset for the Rams.
Copain trying to stay hot. Front iron this time. Thomas up high. Big rebound. Almost an over and back. Kept alive by Johnson. First appearance for Kevin Johnson. Out of Cincinnati, former co-Mr. Basketball in the state of Ohio. Pushed down low on the established post by Corey DeBerry. That'll be his first.
A lot of action down low. Good call. Push off by DeBerry. Offensive foul. Rams ball.
DeBerry lost 25 pounds and is down to 3% body fat. And a really good offseason, as did many Bearcats in their offseason conditioning. For Coach Mick Cronin. They are lean and athletic, these Bearcats, no question about that. Hamdi scores in the paint. And 10 points against Duke, Pete, and 13 against Wisconsin.
Right.
Playing well against some good competition.
They need him. They need some size and physicality up front. From the Bearcats, I'm going inside. Throw the ball into DeBerry.
DeBerry, right on cue, is fouled. Right low block. Must have heard Pete Gillinson.
What? They're so big and strong, Dave. They got to keep going inside. Work inside out if you're the Bearcats. And Copain is a very smart player, so when he's on the floor, I'm sure they'll do that.
Tillman's first off the VCU bench. Coriante DeBerry, senior from Holland, Michigan, west part of the state, shoots here. Has one more. Never miss a moment of college basketball with the CBS Sports app. Every play, every score, every game, and every highlight. And as they happen, download the CBS Sports app right now. DeBerry hits the second, shoots 65% from the free throw line. Doug Brooks makes his first appearance for VCU. Junior guard out of Lake Wales, Florida. And Lewis is out. Guard play so critical. Melvin Johnson quiet so far. VCU is going to make a run back to the tournament. The guards like Melvin Johnson. They'll really take this team over.
Yep. Yeah, very talented guard, especially Melvin Johnson. They need a scoring punch besides Melvin Johnson. He's really doing it. Who's it going to be? Bilberry, maybe the young man right there. Ahmad, handy, he might do it. So he's got to get help for Melvin Johnson, who's one of the top guards in the country.
Plenty of defensive help. Helps Clark, but he travels on the way to the basket. Right back to VCU. Johnson scoreless so far, Pete, in our game. What is UC doing well against Melvin Johnson?
Well, they deny him the ball, so the Rams got to look for him a little bit more, and they got to set some screens for him, help him get free a little bit.
Almost 20 points a game. Melvin Johnson, fourth best in scoring in the A-10, entering play here today. He told us after the shoot-around he'd like to get to 11 threes made in a game to set the all-time VCU single-game record, held by Troy Daniels with 10. Johnson denied this time. Great defense down low by Jacob Evans, the third for Cincinnati. Snuffs out Melvin Johnson's attempt.
Cincinnati plays tremendous defense.
Evans on the other end gets it done. How about that? Jacob Evans, the third, the freshman from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, off the UC bench.
Very often when you play terrific defense, you come back down the end, David, and you do a good job offensively.
Bilberry drives the paint, floats off the glass and hits. Impressive move for Corey Bilberry. Was all mid-continent conference twice at Oral Roberts. He graduated and was eligible right away to play at VCU. I'm not overly in favor of that rule. I still want to see guys sit out a year, regardless of the situation on transfer.
I agree with you 100%. Play 6 years, that's fine. Get your master's.
Exactly.
Takes a year and a half to get your master's anyway.
DeBerry had it stripped. Bilberry, loose change. Here's Bilberry pulling up. And hits a three. Offensive foul.
We got a great count. We got a terrific game. Caution, havoc. We saw that sign. Stick with us. We got a great game in Richmond.
Rare brain condition, Pete, that he suffered from. He said, really, after he got over those first serious headaches, he's felt pretty good since. The doctors, as a precautionary measure, wanted him to sit out the rest of last season because stress could bring on more problems. Feels great now.
He does. We talked to him before the game, and he seemed great, looked great. So that's great news for the Cronin family and the Bearcat Nation.
Lewis penetrates. Lost it, though. And a steal for Copain. Johnson thought about a very long three and wisely sets up in the half court. Here's Kevin Johnson. Blocked away by Mo Alley Cox and some help from Brooks. And a foul call. Doug Brooks picks it up. First on Brooks, only shooting 26% from the field this year. Was 2 of 15 against Georgia Tech the other night, and a very tough loss for VCU on the road in Atlanta. And Johnson has one more. Clark out. Thomas returns for Cincinnati.
It's important he makes this shot now so they can get into their press. Sometimes On the missed shot, they'll do it also. Two-two-one zone press by the Bearcats. Trying to slow them down, make them play against their defense twice.
Near steal for Johnson. Brooks, nice move across the timeline.
Cincinnati goes back to a 2-3 zone. They're doing that because VCU does not shoot the ball great from the perimeter other than Melvin Johnson. So they're going to cheat. He's not in the game right now, so it's a good decision.
Bilberry front iron this time a miss. 7 points for Corey Bilberry. And his first miss from the floor. 7 points for him to lead the way for VCU. Thomas, bumped by Ali Cox, no whistle. Wow, he banks it in. Pete Gillen, what time is it?
It's 4:27 in Richmond, Virginia. The banks are open. Make your deposit. Get some interest.
On a Saturday. On they a are open, Pete Gillen.
Exactly.
Unplanned, but UC will take it. Bilberry runs into trouble. Collapsing defense. And the help D is so impressive with Cincinnati. Yeah. Thomas, other end. Passing. Evans.
Wow.
Off the side of the backboard. Great recovery defense. Moali Cox was everywhere.
Here we go. Nice penetration by Shaq Thomas. Goes way up. Bang! The banks are open on Saturday late in the afternoon, Dave. That's unusual, but we'll take it. You got to make a deposit. You'll get some interest. You make that deposit now. They're all line drives in a book, like baseball. They all count.
In the book, that was nice, perfect swish, plan, top of the key, right?
Yep. Some players, the next shot they take, they try to bank it. Show the last one, they wanted to bank it.
Brooks nearly lost it. Evans, good pressure defense. Johnson scoreless so far. It's the fourth best score in the Atlantic 10. Top of the key, trying to change that, another miss. And Melvin Johnson is 0-for-4 from the field so far today.
Credit Cincinnati's defense.
Thomas spins, kick out. Here's Evans up top. Back iron miss on a three. Lewis, defensive glass for VCU. In transition, finishes. That's the way he played last year for VCU.
Exactly. Now I think his confidence is rising right now. Yeah, VCU's got to pick up the tempo a little bit, get the crowd into the game a little bit more, be a little bit more aggressive, I think, defensively. A little bit of pressure.
Here's Frank Cobb up top. That's a three-pointer for Cobb.
Cobb is streaky. He gets it going. He can light up three or four and a half.
30th three made of the year, Pete, for Farad Cobb. That's tops on the UC roster. He's our leading scorer, almost 12 points a game. It's a balanced Cincinnati offensive attack, and we've documented how good their defense is. I think they're very dangerous in the American Conference.
No question. Certainly one of the top teams in the American.
Timeout. Sold out. Siegel Center again. Havoc. So tough to go up against. But Cincinnati.
Coach of the year in his first year at Chattanooga. And I'm sure he'll do a wonderful job here. But it's tough to replace a legend like Chaka Smart. But Will Wade will do a fabulous job.
Brand new basketball development center across the street. Let's face it. Chaka Smart. VCU fans owe pretty big debt to the amazing era and run that Chaka created here in Richmond. Lewis open. Long three. Back iron miss. Thomas has a long rebound. Really put the Rams on the map. Anthony Grant did a nice job before that. But Chaka Smart brought Ram basketball to a brand new level.
No question. Tremendous job. And it was a national name. What a story. Going to the Final Four in 2011.
Cobb in trouble. Hamdi has a block, but a whistle and a foul first. Sends Cobb to the line. Transfer from Northwest Florida State College. And a senior from West Palm Beach. Cobb had 5 threes against Norfolk State earlier this week, a win for Cincinnati. And he was a three-point threat. He had 6 against Bowling Green earlier this year. That's the most in a single game in the American Conference this season. Hamdi picked up that foul. Up next, join CBS Sports Network's experts at the Gridiron in the studio for the latest edition of Inside College Football. It's Bowl Mania. It starts today, Pete, leading up to the Cure Bowl right here on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. First ever bowl game in our network's history. We can't wait for that one. San Jose State of the Mount West Conference, Georgia State of the Sun Belt. From Orlando, we make history on CBS Sports Network.
It'll be a lot of fun. Great city, Orlando, Florida.
Cobb hits a pair. Largest Bearcat lead of the day at 7.
On VCU, I'm trying to get the ball to my main guy, Melvin Johnson. Set some screens for him. He's got to get more touches. He's averaging 19 a game.
Travel against Humvee.
If I'm VCU, I'm going to a zone now because Cincinnati's getting the ball inside a lot and they're really driving to the basket a lot. Good call. Moved his feet. Maybe in junior college you can do that. Can't do that. Division one.
Went to Lee College in Texas. Was a star there. Originally a commit. University of Houston in the American Conference. Off the Cincy miss. Here's Bilbury. Lewis finds Gilmore. Ellis the block. Foul call. Octavius Ellis challenging Michael Gilmore.
Nice cut to the basket by Gilmore. That's what you have to do. You have to attack the rim. Make the officials make a decision.
Ellis has been very quiet, Pete. Surprising for Cincinnati. That was his second foul, so he'll be coming out, replaced by DeBerry after the free throw here by Gilmore.
He was complaining to the officials about that. He knew he's coming out. Usually, if you get two fouls with Mick Cronin, you sit the rest of the half. Well, we'll see. I used to bring guys back in, Dave. Sit him for a while, gambled. That's why I'm on Boot Hill now. With you, hanging out.
Ooh. I've been to Boot Hill, actually.
It's not pretty.
In Dodge City, Kansas. Yeah, it's not pretty, and we're in a much better spot here.
No question about it. Staying with the man-to-man, which has been good, but I'd like to see him pack in the zone and keep Cincinnati out of the paint.
Freshman Justin Jennifer into the Bearcat lineup for the first time. Here's Shaq Thomas, tennis shoe. Against Gilmore, bumped on the way to the basket. No shot.
Another example of him getting deep in the paint. Shaq Thomas getting to the rim.
Two fouls on Gilmore. Sophomore from Jacksonville heads to the bench, and Tillman replaces him. Such a big emphasis. College basketball officiating this year. Freedom of movement. J.D. Collins, National Supervisor of Officials. A nice conference call with him this week. And scoring is up.
Scoring
fouls are up.
No question, Dave. Scoring's up 6 points per team per game. And also possessions are up. 4 possessions per team per game. So I think it's certainly a more interesting game for me. More exciting, more fun for the fans.
I agree. Here's Clark. Wow, wild shot. Way too strong off the glass. Lewis on the move for VCU. Humvee. And one.
Great pass by Jaquan Lewis. That's the way to take it to the cup. Nice finish by Ahmed Humvee, junior college player. Going to the rim. The two big guys up there, DeBerry and Gary Clark. Nice finish by Ahmed Humvee.
And completes a three-point play. Might have been going up for the dunk. Quadri Moore is in because the foul on DeBerry was his third. Pete, he's in the bench. Ellis is already there with two fouls. So Mick Cronin's bigs in foul trouble in the first half. Yep.
Quadri Moore is in right now. 6'8 sophomore from Linden, New Jersey.
Foul call against VCU on a hold.
Last year, that would not have been a foul. But he was riding him. He kept his arm on. You can't do that. You can't
arm bar. Any exactly. Checking after the initial one touch you're allowed on defense, that's it.
Right, you can't keep pounding. You can't keep touching, as you said. But one push and then got to get off.
Troy Copain up top for Moore. Meet him with a foul trouble. Gets a nice pass. Right low block. Can't finish. Humvee the rebound. Lewis jets up court. Bilbury, three more. This place is rocking.
These fans, they love their Rams.
71st straight sellout at the Siegel Center. And it's jumping right now. Seven to shoot for Thomas. Four to shoot. Shaq Thomas. Humby defensive glass. Lewis. Fast breaking. Tillman. Can't finish. Thomas, big rebound. Here's Cobb. He'll pull up for three. Bingo! Wow! Long range shot for Rod Cobb's second three ball.
He's got it rolling this afternoon for Rod Cobb.
Second in the American Conference entering this game. 2.6 made threes per game. 45% is second to James Woodard of Tulsa from three. Bilbury looking for a third three in the first half. Over the back foul on Hamdi. That's his second.
Cincinnati is a terrific defensive team. They attack the basket. Here we go. Here comes VCU. They're pushing it. Jaquan Lewis trailing Bilbury. Great offense by the Rams.
Bilbury, two threes, Pete. He's got 10 points to lead the way. He's been the offensive threat, the Oral Roberts transfer, and not Melvin Johnson, who's 0 for 4 and no points for the fourth leading scorer in the A-10.
When you're 0 for 4, you got to get out in transition and try to take the ball to the basket and drive the ball a little bit more. See the ball go in, whether it's a free throw or a layup. But how about Jaquan Lewis? We're talking about him struggling. Will Wade told us last couple of games been great this afternoon.
Front end, 1-1. Miss for Quadri Moore. Who's got it? Foul on Clark. Make it Evans the third, his first. Jonathan Williams is into the game for the first time for VCU. Sophomore from right here in Richmond who played his prep ball. But St. Benedict's in New Jersey, that great program, the Gray Bees.
Yep. Danny Hurley was a coach there for a while before he moved on to the college ranks. Now he's at University of Rhode Island doing an excellent job in the A-10.
Bilbury, front end, 1-1, front iron, miss. Cobb, Williams knows they got to defend him quickly. Follow layup, almost put in by Clark. A break. Coach Wade, first year, taking over VCU for Shaka Smart. Tight game.
On to Jaquan Lewis, kicked it out, the first shot.
Melvin Johnson has been very quiet so far, 0 for 4. Averaging 19-plus points a game coming into this game today. And a nice chat with him after the team shoot-around. He says he's got those goals up on his wall in his room here on the VCU campus. I want to make 11 threes in a game, set a record. And go for the all-time three-point career record. He's got 211 entering play here. Lewis, circus shot through traffic, and a foul called on the rebound.
He was fortunate. That was a bad decision. First bad decision by Jaquan Lewis this afternoon. There was too much traffic in there. When he penetrates, everybody comes around. Then you kick it out. You try to force that shot up. He knows. He waved to the coach. Coach, my bad.
Cobb's first foul here, Pete. Sends Tillman to the free throw line. Sophomore and the Rams leading rebounder. At 18 points, a career best earlier this week against Georgia Tech in that loss in Atlanta. But misses that free throw. Evans has the rebound. Here comes Cincinnati again. Copain for Clark.
Clark's not a great perimeter shooter. Better in the paint.
Cobb is the outside threat.
I'd go inside if I'm the Bearcats. Get it to Clark.
Here's Clark. Five to shoot. Molly Cox on him. Evans a third up top. Way short on a three-point try. Grazed the front iron. Doug Brooks, defensive rebound. Here's Brooks. Tipped out of bounds by Evans III. 20 to shoot here for VCU.
What I would do if I'm VCU coach, I would say, all right, let's go pick and roll. Two of our top players, Melvin Johnson and Mo Alley Cox. Let's get Mo Alley in the game. Get him involved. Get the big guy invested in this game.
He's been quiet. Only 1 of 2 from the field and 2 points for Mo Alley Cox. And that was a dunk early in the first half. Tillman baseline, nice catch. Reverse layup, can't hit. Finds the rebound, battling amongst the bigs. How about Justin Tillman's 1-2, and it's his first field goal.
That's all Hunt. Justice Tillman had 17 points recently against Georgia Tech. Had a great game.
A career best, hit all six of his free throws too. Moore up top, long range shot, wow, wide right. That's a brick. Clark, long rebound.
Bearcats go inside. Get the jumper unless you're wide open.
Lewis, the trip on Jacob Evans, the third.
Tillman misses the shot, goes after it. Three guys around him, three Cincinnati players. Heck of a finish by Justin Tillman. Only a sophomore from Detroit, Michigan. We talked to Will White yesterday. He loved Justin Tillman. He said he's just young, but he's got a big, big heart, gutty guy. Playing against some bigger guys, but he really is a great competitor.
Second foul on Lewis a moment ago, and Tillman asked for his release. Evans the third makes the free throw after Shaka Smart left for Texas. Shaka Smart, three top recruits left with him. One followed him to Texas, two went to other schools. And Larrier, who is the top-rated recruit in the last 30 years at VCU, transferred to UConn. Lots of change. Not easy for Will Way to take over.
No question. I'm Cincinnati now. I'm pressing. My point guard's out of the game, Jaquan Lewis. Melvin Johnson, outstanding play, but he's not a point guard. You got to come after him. You're the Bearcats. Letting Melvin do whatever he wants.
Rams coming off 13-point loss at Georgia Tech earlier this week. Bilbury trying to stay hot, does! In the corner! Three balls, first half, Corey Bilbury.
Time Cincinnati let VCU do whatever they want. Wide open jump shot. Got to be more aggressive defensively. You're the Bearcats, especially without Jaquan Lewis in the game.
He's got all three, Pete, of their three-pointers in this first half. Copain falling down, finds more. Way out of his range. 10 to shoot. Final 90 seconds, fading first half clock. Good pass. Down low for Moore. Blocked away with a follow, put up and in. Crashing the boards. Evans the third. How about that play by the freshman? Brooks the fake. Right wing jumper too strong. Tillman should have come down with it first. Tried the stick back. Tie up. Things get physical with Kevin Johnson and Mo Alley-Cox. Arrow pointed in the direction of BC with 1:09 left in our first half.
Missed shot here now. No play for the weak at heart. In the paint, in the mud, in Bloody Nose Lane. Wouldn't mess with either one of those guys.
Got muscles on their muscles, Pete.
They do.
That's a lot of muscles.
I wear my helmet if I was around those guys.
Exciting, entertaining first half here from Richmond. A minute to go in the opening 20. Johnson, can he get going? Wow, way off. Barely got some iron, and Bilbury fouled Thomas in the corner, battling for the rebound.
And credit to Cincinnati defense. They're doing a fabulous job on Melvin Johnson. Now, Melvin, when you're struggling, you got to drive the ball a little bit, Dave. Maybe post up once in a while. Go to the offensive glass on rare occasion. Just can't make a shot right now. 0 for 5, 0 for 1 from three-point land. One assist. It's a long game, but he's got to adjust now. You got to be able to make adjustments when you're a good player, and you're certainly a terrific player.
Redshirt senior from Paterson, New Jersey, Shaq Thomas. Has one more. 9.6 rebounds against Norfolk State on Tuesday. Win in the UC campus. Career best numbers for Shaq this year, 8.5 points, almost 5 rebounds per game. He's played well. Key role for Cincinnati.
It's a big, big game for both teams and for both conferences. The American is an outstanding conference, and the A-10, it helps their RPI, whoever wins this game. So it's a big, big game for the schools and also for their leagues.
Great point, not just these two schools. But VCU, let's face it, must win time for them here tonight. Johnson, just like Pete said, trying to drive, get things going, fouled before he lays it in.
I like his mindset. Got to get him going.
Team foul, first half against Cincinnati. Johnson's first. He'll leave, replaced by Farad Cobb. Johnson has another. Finally, first point of the game for Melvin.
When he sees the ball go in the basket now, his next jump shot he's going to make because he gets a little confidence. He sees the ball go in. Okay, I'm okay now. If he gets a good look, he'll make the next perimeter shot.
Got 36 points, 8 made threes against Florida State of the ACC in a neutral site game. A loss for the Rams in Atlanta. VCU has lost some very good teams this year. That's not the problem. Duke and Wisconsin, two finalists from last year. Georgia Tech, Florida State from the ACC. But four losses this late in the year, before the very tough A-10, they just can't lose this game.
Exactly, Dave. It's a must-win. Melvin Johnson told us that. I go inside now from the Bearcats. Go to Gary Clark, number 11.
11-second differential. Shot and game clock. Jennifer, the lefty. Too strong. Near put back by Gary Clark. Shot clock turned off. Timeout called by Will Wade. Coaches can no longer call timeouts during live play. That happened earlier this year to Will Wade against Duke of the Garden. Didn't get the acknowledgement from the Ogden. Been two against Middle Tennessee, and his career best here in Richmond, 17 points against Wisconsin, that loss to the Badgers. Were you surprised by Bo Ryan's departure this week?
I was. I thought he'd wait to the end of the year, but as you know, he wants to get his assistant, Gary Clark, the job. That's why he did it. He loves Gary Clark. Been together a long time, so that's why he left midseason.
Final moments of the half. Here's Johnson with 2 seconds. Launches a long three. Can't hit this time. Only two first half points for Melvin Johnson. 0 for 6 from the field. 0 for 2 from 3. We know how good he is, though, from long range. Melvin Johnson, the star for the Rams after the shoot-around today. Desperation time for VCU. Four losses already. Cannot afford another one here tonight.
Definitely can't, Dave. They got to get a signature win to help them get back in the big dance when the bids come out in March. First 4 minutes of every game are very important in the second half. Who's going to grab the game by the throat?
Ellis very quiet in the opening 20. Did not have a field goal. Lost it there. Trying to gain position. Low left block. Johnson kicks out to Bilbury. Back iron this time. Gilmore, strong weak side rebound. And Lewis resets in the half court.
VCU's an excellent offensive rebounding team. They know they don't shoot it great from the perimeter. They go get it. They had 15 offensive boards against a very good rebounding Georgia Tech team in their last game.
Johnson step back. Gilmore tries a long range shot. That's a three. First VCU lead of the day. And an unlikely three-point shooter, Michael Gilmore, has his fifth triple of the season. Saw him working hard this morning at the shoot-around on his three ball. Hit that one. Copain short. His own triple. Lewis long rebound.
I thought Lewis was terrific in the first half, Dave. Good pace, under control, only one turnover in 15 minutes, two assists.
Molly Cox, free, the and one for the big guy.
A little pick and roll. Daquan Lewis with a great pass to Mo Ali Cox. Get the ball to the big fella. No help. Nice finish. And you go into the glass, use the glass. You have more of a margin of error when you use the backboard, especially in traffic.
Jimmy Graham, Antonio Gates, Tony Gonzalez, all former college basketball players who became NFL tight ends and stars. Molly Cox has had some looks from some NFL teams. He hasn't played football since his Pop Warner days, but the body size and the great physical attributes at about 6'5", 250, he could be a good one.
No question. Nice tight end or a weak side linebacker.
Right now, let's think about basketball. Big three-point play there. Rams by four. Cobb is held on the way to the basket. Fouls on Johnson.
Here we see new rule. You can't keep the hand on him. Melvin Johnson kept the hand on him. Good call by the official. Freedom of movement. Big key this year.
Can Ellis get going? He's fouled. That's three fouls on Lewis. The help defense down low against Octavius Ellis. So Lewis is going to have to sit here. Ellis has been silent in the game so far. First point of the ball game so far for Octavius Ellis. Some key rule changes, Pete, we talked about throughout our broadcast.
Shot clock 35-30. Coaches can't call timeout in a live ball situation. Timeouts are reduced 5-4. And the removal of the 5-second closely guarded rule. Those are some of the big ones.
I like them all. That was the miss. The goal by the officiating supervisors, a more free-flowing offensive game, and we're seeing that so far. 6+ points per game, scoring's up so far.
And more possessions, and the games are, you say, more free-flowing up and down. I think much better. It's early in the season. Everybody's adjusting. The players, the coaches, the officials. But I think it's a big, big step right now.
Bilber the bump. Case in point right there. As Evans the third can get by Corey Bilber. That's his second. You don't want to see the game slowed down by a lot of perimeter fouls, but players are getting the idea they just can't bump and hand check.
Well, they'll adjust, Dave. It's going to take a while. It's not going to be perfect this year. It's going to take a while. Here we see a zone. I like this little change of pace. Because Cincinnati's been controlling the paint in the first half. An example.
Ellis had it blocked. Mo Alley Cox, the rejection. Here comes Johnson.
I go to Bilberry. He's hot right now. Run him off some screens.
Game high 13 points. The only player in double figures. Johnson lost it. Fraud Cobb has the steal. Copain from Midlothian right outside Richmond. Back iron miss. Evans a third. And a foul down low. Going to be Johnson again. That's his second quickly here in the second half. Tough night for Johnson so far.
He's trying real hard, Dave. That time he over-penetrated and the ball got knocked away for a turnover for Melvin Johnson. You just got to take a deep breath, let it come to him.
0 for 6 from the field so far. Copain on the inbounds play has got 9 points. I know family and friends love that.
Yeah. Terrific player. He's a leader of the team both on and off the court. Very smart player.
Assist to turnover ratio, best in the American Conference. Entering play here tonight, and Mick Cronin pointed that out to us in our meeting with him pregame, how steady Copain has been. 10 to shoot for Brooks up top. Need some help. Can Johnson hit a field goal? Melvin Johnson, 2 to shoot. Spins, wild shot, back iron. Rebound for Clark. Cobb, bit out of control. Collects and scores on the baseline. First double-figure score for Cincinnati is Farad Cobb with 10 points. Melvin Johnson takes a timeout. Underway second half. Must win for VCU. 23rd-ranked Cincinnati wants a...
Will Wade's a very young man, 33 years old, and he's doing an excellent job. He's a hard worker. Very close friends with John Rothstein, our own inside college basketball from CBS Sports Network, and done a great job here so far. Played a tough schedule, I think. The toughest schedule in the A-10 so far. GW has played a good schedule, but I think I give the Rams the toughest schedule at this point in the season.
32 years old, fourth youngest coach in the nation. In the corner, Johnson. Wow, way off on a three. Cleaned up down low. Molly Cox up to 7 points. Pressure from Jonathan Williams.
Got a heck of a game here. Stick with it. It's going right down to the last possession. Who wants it?
Arbuckle, Georgia State quarterback, 6 in the FBS, more than 346 yards a game and 26 touchdown passes. It's going to be fun tonight.
It's going to be fun. Stick with us. CBS Sports Network. Change of defense now by VCU. It's a zone defense. It's a 1-1-3 that goes into a 2-3. They're doing that because Cincinnati's getting into the paint too much. They're hurting him on the glass in the lane. I like it. Not going to live and die with it, but it's a good change of pace.
Evans a third. Bullet pass down low, and Clark can't handle it.
Change of defense. Turnover by Cincinnati. Great job by the young coach, Will Wade.
8 UC turnovers in the game so far. 6, as you see, for the Rams.
I would stay with it. Cheat the Cobb if I'm VCU.
Brooks up top. Thud. Bad miss. Malik Cox had the rebound, had it stripped, and a foul called under the basket against Cincinnati.
You said it before, Dave, a couple of times. This is a crucial game for VCU. They need a signature win against a top-notch team.
Ellis has been completely absent of the game so far for Cincinnati. That's his third foul. He's only attempted 2 field goals and has 1 point.
Well, the guard's got to get him the ball. He's got to work a little harder to get free, but he's got to want the ball. You see, yep. Oh, Allie Cox is in there. Getting fouled. Gary Clark, can't have your arms around him.
Three fouls on Ellis, three fouls on Clark. Gary Clark is out. Shaq Thomas back in for Cincinnati. There's some foul trouble for the Bearcats. Coriante DeBerry has three as well off the UC bench.
The Bearcats play some zone. I consider a zone now if I'm Cincinnati. Pack it in. Right now, VCU's not knocking him down from three-point land.
Williams, great move, Pete, in traffic. Little crossover, but couldn't finish. That was nifty.
But they stay in a zone. Yes, they're staying in a zone, which I like. 1-1-3. It almost looks like a 1-3-1, but it's really a 1-1-3. The forwards come up high. Now it goes back to a 2-3.
Bombs away for Cobb. Ellis thought about the follow flush. Instead, brings it down and is fouled down low.
The problem with a zone, as you know, Dave, is you got trouble boxing out. Here's a long shot. Nobody boxes out. Octavius Ellis, a big man, goes way up. Gets fouled. Two free throws now for the big guy. Got a screen out. Nobody touched him. But he's ball watching. Pack the cup.
Gilmore's third foul a moment ago. Ellis has one more. Second on the team, almost 62% from the field. Hamdi and Tillman are back into the VCU lineup. Ellis, second team All-American Conference last year. MVP of the Barclays Center Classic earlier this year. Needs to be a big factor for Cincinnati if they're going to make a run at the American Conference this year. The best team in that league, SMU, undefeated, cannot play in the conference tournament due to NCAA sanctions.
Exactly.
Four lead changes in the second half. Back and forth game here from Richmond.
Right now, Melvin Johnson's out of the game because he's been struggling this afternoon.
Johnson Williams, five to shoot. Floats, had it blocked. Shaq Thomas, snuffed that try out. Copain on the move. Evans III thought about a three. The freshman floats. Stick back short as well. Right back to VCU.
Good defense by, here we go, by Cincinnati. Nice block. Shaq Thomas, they're off to the races.
Melvin Johnson back in here, Pete.
Okay. I like
trying
it.
Trying to get his confidence back. Had a tough, tough game. 0 for 8 from the field. 0 for 3 from 3. He's one of the best scorers in the country.
Tremendous player. Averages 19 a game. 36 points against Florida State, who's a fabulous team. What he has to do is drive the ball more, use a pick and roll a little bit, and even post up. Right now, his jumper's not going, Dave.
They call him the Bronx Bomber. Bronx native, St. Benedict's Prep in New Jersey. That great program we talked about producing Melvin Johnson. Under 10 to shoot here. Here's Johnson floating. Can't get that elusive first field goal down. Ellis, loose change, rebound. Long outlet, Thomas on the move. Passing to Johnson. Nice fake, and he's fouled. Good pump fake. You love the pump fake, Pete.
I love the violent pump fake. Chuck Daly, the late great coach of the Olympic team in 1992 and the Detroit Pistons, loved the violent pump fake. You do that to get the defense in the air, then you go up strong, you try to get a three-point play. That's why I use the pump fake. Defense tries to time the shot. You show the fake. Violent pump fakes, a lost art in the game, Dave. Not many people do that today, big guys.
Johnson's tough night continues. That was his third foul. Kevin Johnson shooting for Cincinnati has one more free throw coming up, and Melvin's got to take a seat. A nice chat after the shoot-around today with Melvin. Wants to get into the ATF or FBI, criminal justice major when he's done playing basketball. Could have a long pro career somewhere. NBA, NBDL overseas with that shooting that usually is so good.
Yeah, he can play somewhere. Sure.
Very impressive young man.
With basketball, every game is a completely unique experience. So he was great a couple games ago. He was excellent against Georgia Tech, great against Florida State, 36-17. Right now he's struggling with 2 points. So anything can happen. That's why it's such a great game.
And Bilber has been the offensive star, Pete, back into the game. The Oral Roberts transfer has 13 lone double-figure score for VCU. Here he is right on cue. Someone's got to take over offensively for the Rams here. Johnson, obviously an off night. Tillman baseline. Doesn't get a roll. Quick release there. Didn't finish.
Yep, that was Tillman's shot against Georgia Tech, as you know. 18 points. Led the Rams in their last game. That little short corner.
Critical time in the game for these fragile Rams who've had some tough losses. We talked about it. 5-4. Copain. Up top for Thomas. Would have been a big three. Hamdi kept it alive for Bilbury.
Good job by Cincinnati. Get back in their fast break D, Dave. Nice job in their transition.
You're right. Their recovery defense in transition has been fantastic tonight. Great athletes on this UC roster. Five to shoot. Baseline. Bilbury driving and scoring. Corey Bilbury up to 15 now. Too shy of his VCU best. Career high came at Oral Roberts against Nebraska Omaha a couple years back at 34 points. He's been a big factor tonight.
He only averages 10 a game, so he's already past his average with 11 minutes and about 45 seconds to go.
Good pass down low to bury the finish. Copain found him. And a post up for Coriante to bury. Bilbury at the end, blocked away. Evans the third, the freshman, big defensive play. Corey Bilbury has been a factor. 59 career double-figure games. Most of those, of course, came at Oral Roberts. He graduated, transferred to VCU, and with Melvin Johnson struggling.
For VCU. So both teams are doing well. Very balanced game. Both teams are very, very close to each other. Whoever has the ball, the last possession is going to win. There's Mick Cronin, nice and calm right now. He's very volatile. Done a fabulous job with the Bearcats.
And keep in mind, everyone, that Pete Gillen, so prophetic in our game at the Leah Chorus Center on the Temple campus Sunday, called OT coming. That was early in the second half, St. Joe's Temple. It went overtime, won by the Hawks on the road. So if he's calling it, it's going to happen.
Yep.
That's what Pete Gillen does. Go pay in the miss.
Whoever has the ball, the last possession is going to win. It's
all right, remember that. Remember he said that. Johnson can't hit. Physical scrap. Rebounding position. It's a battle down there. It's going to be DeBerry, and that's his fourth.
Dave, the last time I was right, though, on a call, Moby Dick was a minnow.
Come so on, stop.
I don't want to get too overconfident, but I
just right said you called it correctly Sunday up in Philly.
I did. All right, here we go. Right down to the end. It's a great game. Two teams have been to the NC tournament 5 years in a row, as you know. So this team, both in, could go again, but it's a big win for whoever gets this to get there.
Bilbury way too hard, but he is fouled on the way to the basket. Nice crossover by Corey Bilbury, who has taken over. That's something Will Wade pointed out to us today pregame, that Will Wade really a secondary role, mostly off the bench. This is his fifth start. Talk about Jordan Burgess missing because of a concussion. But at Oral Roberts, at a lower level of mid-major basketball, Bilbury was the man.
Yes, he had an excellent career there. Leading scorer, terrific player.
About 16 in the game.
Right now,
back in.
Transfers all over the place, Dave. I don't like it. People can transfer, it's fine. You have that right, of course. But everybody should have to sit out here. That's my thoughts. Because it devastates some of these lower schools, these mid-majors. What about Drexel? Fifth leading scorer in the country, Damian Lee left. Drexel's 1-6 right now. Cleveland State's been devastated the last couple of years. So he transfer, but sit out a year. And then the big schools will not take these guys. They won't have them on scholarship for 2 years and let them play 1 year.
Good agreement. In football and basketball, you got to sit out. You can transfer. Doesn't matter if you graduate. Doesn't matter if you have health issues with your family. You got to sit out a year.
Exactly.
Across the board. One rule. Make it easy. There's 600 transfers plus last year. It's too many. 600.
Yeah. Wait, yeah.
When it is one basketball.
It's Mick Cronin. He's feisty. Here we go.
His joint is jumping again. Ellis trouble with the inbounds play. He's out of bounds.
Crowd got that turnover. Look at these guys. They're fired up. These gals. Whoever wants this game the most, whoever gets in the mud and the glue is going to win the game. Two even teams.
Basketball IQ for the fans here. Off the charts. They know how important this game is. Bilbury drives in. Can't finish though. Brooks scraps for the rebound. Baseline for Bilbury. Tough shot with a left in traffic. Rebound kick that out. A third.
Yep. All the defenses around, you got to kick that out.
Copain, good handle. And the finish for Troy Copain. That's great.
Terrific player. Very smart. Great basketball IQ.
2 points for Copain. Second Bearcat in the double figures in the game here. Right back to UC.
That time, yeah, trying to overplay him. Brooks. Copain got the angle. Nice finish. Nice finish in traffic.
Top 10 points. Copain leads the Bearcats now with 11. And Ellis get going. Watched by Hamdi.
Go inside. Either Clark or Ellis. Get the ball to a big fella.
Good call. Right on cue. Clark double team. Great feed by Copain. Perfect entry pass there. A foul call.
He's a tremendous player. And the more you watch him, the more you admire him. He's a bright young man. Very intelligent. A lot of poise. Makes the big shots. Takes the big shots. The lead of this team on and off the court. Fabulous guard.
Second foul on Brooks there, coach, and 17 foul. Second half for VCU. Here's Clark. Has another. Johnson is back in. The Copain family loves it. Johnson returns. 0 for 9 from the field. 0 for 3 from 3 so far for Melvin Johnson, one of the all-time greats in VCU history. Been a mighty struggle. Clark hits 2. Is Melvin Johnson's confidence.
They go inside to the big guy. Getting the ball, Ahmed Hamdi.
Lewis pulls up. 15-footer. Rattles out. Lewis has the rebound. Johnson has double figures in every game this year. He's just been fantastic until now. Foul on Hamdi down low.
Melvin Johnson's having a tough night, averages 19 a game. End of the shot clock, had to force one up. Here we go in the corner. Makes that very often. Air ball. Credit to Cincinnati defense. Even the floater in the lane, he drove it. So give a lot of credit to the defense of Cincinnati. 2 points, 0 for 9 from the field, Dave, as you mentioned before. Only 2 free throws.
Prior low, 3 times, had 13 points against American, Old Dominion, and Prairie View A&M. That would have been it for Johnson. 13 is a low. And he has just been completely blanketed and shut down tonight. Ellis free throw hits, back to Taylor.
Right, throughout this entire game, Melvin Johnson has been incredibly vocal. Not having that good of a game offensively, but he looked Coach Wade in his eye and he said, do not take me out of the game unless I'm tired. I want to still contribute. And he's been on the bench telling his teammates to rebound, saying to get every second chance shot they can get. So even when he's not playing, he's still contributing to his team, whether it's through his voice or just his presence on the court, guys.
And they need that Taylor so much. Johnson is senior, great leader. We met with him after the shoot-around, mature, intelligent young man. Such a big part of this VCU team. He really is their key. And a foul call on Ellis. Off-ball contact.
Him and Mo Ali Cox are banging each other.
4 fouls on Ellis. So the Barry returns. He's got 4 fouls. The Cincy Bigs feel the heat here with foul trouble.
Good job by Mick Cronin calming him down.
Right, that's a great something. Even though DeBerry has the 4 fouls, you got to get Ellis out.
No question.
You need him down the stretch. He's your best post player. Lewis for Gilmore. Big possession here. Gilmore for 3. You bet.
Gilmore had a lot of poise. He thought about it the first time, second time. Penetration, the defense went off the dribbler. Kicked to him, Gilmore had time and space.
His second 3 made of the game. That ties a career best. 2 triples in a game. Copain, front iron. Gilmore, weak side rebound. Rams can tie with a 3. Thank you. another foul. Corian Tedeberry has fouled out. And part of the new rules in college basketball, like 15 seconds to quickly replace Corian Tedeberry. It is an immediate timeout. A little extra time. But Berry's day is done. So Ellis is going to have to come back in with a four fouls. Ellis actually has four fouls right now. Mo Alleycox misses the front end. Rebound for Clark. One possession game from Richmond. Couldn't be a bigger outing for the home team here with four losses already. And Gilmore got too physical with Clark.
It's a foolish foul. 30 feet from the basket. You don't want to grab somebody in the arm.
You just can't do that. It's clearly been emphasized.
Yep.
Only once. You're allowed one little hand check, one little size up, right? That's it.
Biggest rule, I think, is rule 10.1-4, which has been on the books, but now they're saying we're going to have to enforce this. We want freedom of movement. We want free flowing. One more scoring. We're getting that now. I think it's a great rule change. Still an adjustment period, but I think it's a great change. Yeah, the rule committee's done an excellent job.
Fouls on Gilmore, Pete. That is his fourth. Clark, 7 points, 3 for 3 from the line. Perfect night so far for Gary Clark. The junior from Clayton, North Carolina, hits two big free throws, made a 5-point game. Here's Johnson, 0-for-9 so far.
I go inside, get the ball inside.
Moore, trying to check up. Marley Cox, and it's thrown away. Was it a backcourt violation? Was it tip? Because Jaquan Lewis grabbed it and ran with it and traveled. He's actually called for a traveler. Let's see. He just tipped?
I didn't see it. Might have been
by Copain. Yeah. Lewis assumed it was going to be
a backcourt. Said it was tipped.
It was tipped. So that was the call's travel. Lewis just could have grabbed that and kept the possession alive for VCU. That's a key mental error for Jaquan Lewis. Wow.
The referee overruled the other. Because one said it's a tip. It was a tip. It's okay. Keep the ball. VCU. And the guy said, no, it wasn't.
Bobby Moore drives in. Left-handed shot. Floats and hits. That's a tough field goal for Moore. The sophomore from Linden, New Jersey, has his first bucket of the game.
Danger time now for VCU. Got to get a good shot. Go back inside. Look at Mo Alleycox or Gilmore.
Gilmore in the corner. Lewis. Under 10 to shoot. Bilberry is held. Quadri Moore picks up the foul.
Quadri Moore, terrific shot. Left hand scoop shot in traffic. That time, VCU got bailed out. They were going nowhere. Defense was there.
Bilberry misses the front end of the 1-1. Had been 4-5 from the line. Mo Alleycox. Big offensive rebound. Johnson. Can he finally hit a shot? Not yet. 0-for-10. Bilberry tracks it down. Back to Johnson. Here's Gilmore. Short. Copain. Outlet. Clark. Finish. Gary Clark with a two-handed hammer. Largest Bearcat lead. It's 9 points. Will Wade needs a timeout.
He does. I'd call one right now.
Not going to take it.
No saving it.
Mariah Cox on Moore. Foul.
Nice push ahead by Copain. Gary Clark with the flush. Excellent defense. Left a good offense for the Bearcats. 9-point lead. Biggest lead of the game now. You make your free throws. I go into press now if I'm VCU. Still got plenty of time, but you got to have your defense get your offense going.
Mo Alleycox, back iron miss. Now keep in mind, Pete, Cincinnati comes in 9-2. If they can hang on here, this is a big signature road. True road wins are tough to get at VCU, where at the Siegel Center they're so tough. Two losses for the Bearcats. Butler on CBS Sports Network on a buzzer beater at home by Roosevelt Jones. And then the loss at Xavier, a top 10 team. As Matt Carlin pointed out to us pregame, we've had a good year. Xavier, losing to Xavier's not an upset by any stretch.
No, Xavier's got an outstanding team. They got a chance to go to the Final Four. They're that good, Dave. Athletic, strong. Chris Mack's doing a fabulous job. Cincinnati will go inside to Gary Clark. Get him the ball.
Clark bouncing. Foul the way up. Jacob Evans a third on the aggressive take for the freshman. And free throws coming up here for the Frosh out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
To Evans penetrate. He said Cox is in the restraining circle there. It's 4 foot like the NBA now. They moved it out.
Another name change this year. Evans a third, the leading free throw shooter in the American Conference. 91.7% entering play here tonight. Second best Ronnie Johnson of Houston at 87.9. Very impressive. The freshman hits two. 24 of 26 from the free throw line this year.
I go to Bill Murray now. Get him going. He's hot. Let him off some screens.
VCU really needs something. Crowd's out of the game. Ten to shoot for Johnson. Lewis. Thought about a really long three. High low play. It's kicked. And the shot clock reset to 15. That's a good break for VCU. That possession's breaking down there at the end.
You got to credit Mick Cronin. You see right there. And the Cincinnati defense. They hold their opponents to 59 points a game. And 37% field goal percentage. Great job. That's in the Bearcats' DNA, is their physical, aggressive defense.
13-4, Bearcat run here, Pete. In the last 5 minutes or so. Here's Lewis, knifing through traffic. The fans don't like that call.
Go to some contact on that one, Dave. Lewis goes in, see if they reaches over his arm. That was all ball. Call by the officials. VCU in a 2-2-1, quarter zone press. They want to try to get their defense to get their offense going. Down 10. Get a stop almost every possession now.
Clock in the corner. Bearcats spread it out. Farad Cobb with a fake. He'll float. Can't connect, but finds the rebound. Fresh 30 for the visitors here. And Gary Clark in no hurry. No pain, mature presence. Great ball handler and point guard for Mick Cronin. Very few mistakes. Cobb slipped. No travel call. Copain. Baseline. Shaq Thomas. Travel.
There's a couple of travels on that one. I think the official's doing a good job, but at times it was roller skates. Drive the ball now. Go inside and drive the ball. If you have a wide open three.
Lewis up top, and it's kicks.
Got a heck of a game here. It's not over yet. Bearcats on a run. Rams want this game also. Stick with us here in Richmond.
BYU-Utah out in Vegas. It is all Utes. They're smoking their rivals right now. 35-7. Wow. They haven't played for 3 years. Yeah, I love college football, Pete. That's a fun game in bowl season.
Yeah, you do a great job announcing. You really follow it closely.
Johnson, can he get going here, Pete? Lewis, big shot, big three.
Zone press now, 2-2-1 zone press here by VCU, trying to get some turnovers. Attacking with a 1-3-1.
First three of the game for Jaquan Lewis. Cuts it to 7. VCU desperately needed that triple. 10 to shoot here for Evans, a third. Copain on the spread, way out beyond the arc with 5 to shoot. Kicks in the corner for Johnson. Omby, a big rebound. Lewis is fouled beyond the arc by Copain. 3 free throws coming up for Jaquan Lewis. Potential game changer.
As a coach, you never foul a jump shooter, but you never ever foul a three-point shooter. Payne goes up, got him with the body, just a little bit of the shoulder. Good call.
First foul of the game on Troy Copain. So Lewis, who shoots 82.5% from the line, has another from Dixon, Tennessee. So the last 15 games of last year when Bronte Weber was hurt. Told you about that. He's got one more free throw coming. 16 points, the best for Lewis against Old Dominion of Conference USA. Old Dominion made the NIT Final Four last year.
He makes it. They're going to go into their 2-2-1 three-quarter court zone press. Try to get some steals. Pick up the action a little bit.
Hits three. Four-point game. Crowd back into it. Ten-second call.
Two-possession game. Anything can happen. Whoever has the ball last is going to win.
Six-0 run, thanks to Lewis. Molly Cox is fouled. An aggressive physical play down low with Clark.
Great play. Pick and roll right in the middle of the court. Daquan Lewis, nice pass. Mowally goes up strong off 2 feet. Gary Clark with the foul.
And that's Clark's fourth, Pete. Coriante de Berry has already fouled out for Cincinnati. Ellis has four as well for the Bearcats. Here's Mowally Cox.
He's a good free throw shooter. Coming into the game, he's shooting 73% from the line.
Entering the game, sixth all-time VCU career blocks. There's a good one down low. And clearly good from the free throw line, as Pete pointed out. Two huge free throws. Siegel Center rocking again. Cobb travels.
Rod Cobb goes up.
This game against Cincinnati for the American ranked team would be devastating. Basically, a must win. And now back from 10 points down here, beating 8 straight.
Nice ball screen.
Lewis trying the reverse layup. Tough shot. Molly Cox can't convert on the stick back. Who's got it? Bearcat ball.
Both these teams are double bonus. Good call. Went off Gilmore. Staying in the 2-2-1. Get a guy in the middle now, Bearcats. 1-3-1. That's it. Gary Clark's in the middle. That's where the opening is.
Cobb back for Clark. Floats and can't hit, but he is fouled. On the way to the basket, Gary Clark will shoot two here. He's 4-for-4 on the line for Mick Roberts so far today.
1-3-1, get it to the middle, kick it opposite. Back to Clark, shots halfway down, around in the rim. Great offense by Cincinnati. It's a way to attack the zone. They didn't do that before, Dave. A little bit discombobulated.
Perfect 5-for-5 for the free throw line to Gary Clark. No pain family from nearby Midlothian, Virginia is very happy. And Clark's got one more coming in, shooting 70.4% from the line, 19-27, but perfect so far. 6-for-6 for the free throw line for Gary Clark. He's got 12 points.
Tremendous. Keep running the high pick and roll right in the middle of the court. And now Cincinnati's not adjusting great to it. Here's that pick and roll.
Two minutes left in regulation. 4-point UC lead. Lewis with a left and a finish. Great move to the basket by Jaquan Lewis.
We got a guy in the middle now.
Rob Cobb. Wisely pulls it up.
But then good shot now. Here's Cincinnati. I go inside now to Gary Clark. I think he's got a mismatch inside. VCU goes to the zone. Nice move by Will Wade. Doing that to protect the interior.
Five to shoot. Clark, free throw line. Here's Clark for three. Hits a huge triple. Second. Three. Cobb's second half. Big shot. Lewis again. Blocked from behind by Ellis. But a foul. And Octavius Ellis has fouled out here. Second Bearcat to be DQ'd for Mick Cronin. Three UC players in double figures along with Clark and Copain.
This is Mick Cronin. He said he loves his guys. And he says, you know, we don't have any bad guys. We don't have any knuckleheads. That's nice. He said, sometimes you need knuckleheads. I said, no, you don't. You got a great group of kids, and they play their hearts out for them.
Lewis shoots almost 83% as Johnson sits still without a field goal tonight. Hits the second. He's got 13.
Staying in a 2-2-1, don't press.
Steal. Gilmore. Loose change for Brooks. With a minute to go in regulation. This is fun.
With a high ball screen, attack the basket.
Jaquan Lewis. Mo Alley Cox, good catch. Gilmore's follow flush. He's fouling way up off the Bilberry miss.
Great offense by VCU. Pick and roll. Lewis gets into the middle. Missed jump shot. Nobody screens out. Gilmore goes way up to the moon. Two shots for Gilmore.
Evans, the third, picks up his second foul. And that sends Gilmore to the free throw line where he's 1 of 2 from the game so far tonight. 47.7 left in regulation. This is the first. 2 of 4 from the free throw line entering play tonight on the season. Not many trips. Way short on the second. Evans has the rebound. Foul call. And Gilmore's fouled. Third player foul out in our game here so far.
Yep. Copain's going to the line. He's the guy you don't want to foul. You know, Dave, you have some children, right? Seeing them in action in a sport or a concert.
Absolutely.
Or a play.
Ballet recitals.
Whatever it is, right? It's pressure.
Concerts, absolutely right. Hits the first. 12 points in the game so far for Troy Copain, who's been almost flawless running the Bearcat offense tonight. Gets the roll, hits two. Lead up to 6. Plenty of time for the Rams. Brooks needs help. Alley Cox bails him out. Bilberry! Hits another 3. 4 threes in the game. Timeout call for Corey Bilberry, the transfer from Oral Roberts.
Terrific points. Season high, 20 points. It's a great game. I foul him. Foul him. Foul the freshman.
Nope. Cobb is held by Johnson.
All three are excellent free throw shooters, so pick your poison.
4 fouls on Melvin Johnson. He is 0 for 10 from the field, 0 for 4 from 3 so far. So it's Cobb. 80% free throw shooter coming in, but only 10 attempts on the season. 2 for 2 so far in this game. It's the first. .14 a game high for Cincinnati. Rod Cobb, senior from West Palm Beach, Florida. Johnson's in. Shot clock turned off. Cobb buries 2. 5-point lead.
High ball should go to the basket.
Lewis floats, blocked away by Clark. And he's fouled before he can send the pass out to Ferran Cobb, who was all by himself to finish it off for Cincinnati.
Jaquan Lewis tried to draw the foul, but Clark has that rule of verticality. He's allowed to go straight up. Good no call. He's backing up. Arms are up. Now if he'd lean his arm down and lean into him, we're going to foul.
Clark 6 for 6 from the line so far in this game. Stays perfect. Money as he buries another one.
Terrific player. Only a sophomore, Clayton, North Carolina.
His first miss. 6-point game. Final moments. Bill Murray needs two. Has it? Timeout called by VCU. 22 for Bill Murray. Best effort for him as a VCU Ram.
Guy in a ball.
Inside College Football coming up next on CBS Sports Network, getting us set for the first ever bowl game in our network's history, the Cure Bowl from the Citrus Bowl in downtown Orlando. Georgia State, San Jose State, that's coming your way next.
Trying to get the ball to Cobb.
Foul on Lewis.
Dangerous pass there.
Fighting with propane. Four fouls on Lewis. Copain, who led the American Conference in three-point shooting last year in conference games, 46% in the league. Larry Davis to the right there of Mick Cronin, who took over and led the Bearcats to the NCAA tournament. One more free throw here for Troy Copain. Larry Davis did an amazing job on this.
He did. It wasn't easy coming in, replacing Mick Cronin in the middle of the season. Did a great job. Got him to the big dance and won a game.
Beat Purdue in overtime. Second round. Copain hits two. Eventually lost to Kentucky in the third round. 6-point game. Final moments here. Johnson, can he finally hit a shot? No. It's going to be an 0-for-9 for Melvin Johnson. That should do it from the Siegel Center. It is a signature resume-building road win for Troy Copain. Mick Cronin and Cincinnati, the 23rd-ranked Bearcats, move to 10-2 on the year. 69-63, they win at VCU from the Atlantic 10. For Pete Gillen, Taylor Rooks, and the entire crew, it's Dave Ryan saying so long.